Hi, welcome to Cooking with Me, Mama Pearl. And I decided since adobo was a pretty easy recipe that I would do adobo and the rich, decadent brownie pie. So I hope I haven't timed it right. So anyway, we're gonna start with the adobo because we're gonna let it cook while we prepare the brownie pie. I have a big pot here because we're expecting a lot of people for dinner tonight because it's adobo. And I have just a little bit of oil in the bottom, vegetable oil. And we're gonna start out and we're going to throw in an onion. I chopped up an onion. I always do this before the camera so nobody can see me cry. Okay, you're just gonna throw that in. Okay, yummo, looks good, huh? And at this point, you're gonna let this brown just a little bit, my trusty dusty. I love sauteed onions. I don't know what it is about the smell of sauteed onions. But you don't want it too hot because when we add the garlic, you don't want the garlic to burn. And so you're gonna throw everything in the pot. I know it's like, what? But easy. Then I have two chopped garlic. We're gonna throw those in.
Okay, I know.
You know, if you have company coming and you want your house to smell inviting, just saute a little onion and garlic on the stove and it makes everything smell delicious. So if they're not hungry when they come, they will be hungry when they get there. Okay, so now you have the chicken. It's hard, I had my trifle, which is funny. We're gonna add the soy sauce and vinegar. Now in the recipe, it's about 1 1/4 cups of vinegar. And then you have about 1 1/2 cups of soy sauce. And you want it just enough, but first I'm gonna add the chicken, and I want the chicken to brown just a little bit. And Daddy went cray-cray with the chicken, which is okay. When you're in the Philippines, you tell them you want adobo cut, and they cut it to what you want, so my husband cut this up. Of vinegar, good stuff. Whoop, there's a cup. Ooh, that smells good. Oh, if I can get this open, here we go. And about 1/2 a cup with that. 1 1/2 of vinegar. Whatever vinegar had, this one was the distilled vinegar, which I'll have to get more because we're gonna do Easter eggs. And then you're gonna add about 1 1/2 cups of soy sauce. I don't know if you know, you should shake, it's going everywhere. You should shake your soy sauce because it kind of has a tendency to settle to the bottom. So you wanna make sure that you get the good stuff on the bottom. And if you want to use low sodium soy sauce, you can do that too. We're gonna add the soy sauce. Don't fear, I have another bottle. Never without soy sauce. And then you look in there and you think, okay, so you wanna add just enough water to cover the chicken, okay? Just enough. Now just so you know, adobo is not a soup. It is a thick mixture and you're gonna let this cook down. Look at that. Yummo! I think just a little more water will have it done. And you just put them whole in your dish, just like that. Okay? And then you're gonna put In the Philippines, we call this bay leaf. In the Philippines, they call it a laurel leaf. And you're going to put just one in there. Just one leaf. Okay? Just to give it a little bit of flavor. And then you're going to stir it up. And you're going to turn it to medium. Okay, you're going to let that simmer uncovered. And if you have to add a little more water, you can go ahead and do that. Oh, you're going to... I dropped my lid. And we saved it. You're going to just let that cook until the chicken is tender. And then we'll add... Annalise likes potatoes with hers. So then we will add a boiled, you know, peeled potato in there, and then when the chicken's almost done, then when your potato's done, and you let it, don't try not to add any more liquids to it. You want it to cook down, reduce by like half, so that it gets the chicken done, you get your broth is kind of thick, and if it's too strong for you, then add a little more, strain it, add a little more water. Heat the oven to 325 because you're gonna cook this at a lower, and you're gonna prepare a spring foam pan, okay? So that, and I sprayed it with butter flavored spray, okay? So this is prepared and ready to go. And then you're going to get your butter. And this is 2/3 cup of softened butter. I put it in here and let it get pretty soft. It's been sitting here for a while, okay? And then you're gonna add 1 1/4 cup of sugar to this. And you're gonna beat it. So 1 1/4. I have all my little trusty measuring cups. I like measuring cups. 1 1/4 cup of sugar, and of course you're gonna beat this together. See if I can. Point. You're gonna add corn syrup. You're gonna add 1/2 cup of corn syrup. So before I measure the corn syrup, I spray my cup here because it just, with the butter flavored pan, that way the corn syrup will just roll right out of it and won't stick. I do the same thing when I measure honey. That way you don't have to worry about it sticking to anything. So 1/2 cup of corn syrup. You see it just comes right out of the cup. Prevents it from sticking. And it's fluffy and it's beaded together. And then we're gonna add 2 eggs. Add the eggs one at a time and beat them and incorporate them in there. And this is a very thick mixture. Light and fluffy and yellow that looks, that's what you want it to look like. Then in a separate bowl, you're going to put the dry ingredients. So we're gonna switch here. You're gonna have 1 1/4 cups of flour. And you want a level cup of flour. You don't want it heaping or anything like that. You want it level. So you're gonna go just like that. You want 1 1/4. Level. Okay. And then you want 1/2 cup of, oh, there it is. Baking cocoa. I was like, what did I do with it? Baking cocoa. You want half a cup of baking cocoa. Okay. And then you want half a teaspoon of salt. Salt makes everything taste better. So, woohoo, here we go. Yummo, half a teaspoon of salt. And we're gonna start stirring this up. So now you have your dry, your wet, and your really wet. And you're gonna mix them together into a chocolatey, delicious glob. No, batter. I'm sure they say batter. Okay, let's start it in here. Delicious. We're gonna stir it all in here. Make sure we have all the sides and all the bottom. Yep, that thick and rich. And then you're gonna add your walnuts. If you don't like walnuts, add a different nut, but walnuts is what I recommend to, and I went ahead and cut and chopped up my walnuts. And this is, you know, you can have either 1 to 2 cups of walnuts. Okay, and then you're going to stir those in there. Put it in your spring foam pan and spread it out. It's really thick, so you need to actually kind of push it around and get it in your spring foam pan. I'm going to set mine for 60 minutes. And voila, you let it go. After 60 minutes, voila. Put parchment paper under your cooling rack. You have your brownie pie. You undo the sides, and this is what they call the pie. And at this point, this is when you're going to make your ganache. Now really all a ganache is usually it's a whipping cream and chocolate melted together. So we're going to do that right now. I want to show you the ganache. In a saucepan, you're going to put get 1 cup of whipping cream. And you're gonna heat this on the stove. Okay? 1 cup of heavy whipping cream into your saucepan. And we're gonna heat this up. You don't really wanna boil it, but you want it hot, hot. And then you want 8 ounces of the semi-sweet chocolate. And I cut it up in here. So when this cream is hot enough, you're gonna heat it up really hot and you're gonna put in your chocolate and stir it and let it melt. So we're gonna do that now. Gobo, Daddy put a lid on it. You just keep it stirred. And he's peeling the potatoes, and it doesn't take really a long time to cook the chicken. Wow, look at that. I wish you guys had, whoop. I don't know what kind of lid he's got. Just We still eat it with rice, even though we put potatoes in it. You serve it with rice. You let it all reduce down, put it rice, put your chicken and a little bit of sauce on top, and it's so good. Yeah, that's... See how it's just started to boil? Just barely started. You're gonna shut it off and you're gonna add your chocolate. And it's 8 ounces, which is 2 bars, 2 of the bars. And you're gonna stir it. Okay, we're gonna pour this right over the top. This is where it gets really good. This you should really let cool. It'll form kind of a shell on here. But for purposes of showing you guys how to serve it or what you can possibly do with it, I'm going to slice a piece like a pie, and I'm going to show you how we would like to serve it. If you have company over and you want to impress them, just like that. And voila! Oh my god. Alright, and we'll have 4 more dishes up Monday to see what you want Mama Pearl to make.